Good morning, family and friends. Welcome to the Ang Mo Kio Methodist Church online worship service. We are glad that you are able to join us for worship this morning. We also want to give a very special welcome to any of you who might be joining us for the very first time. So if this is the first time or the first few times you're joining us for the online service video, give a shout out in the live chat. We would love to know who you are. If you need a copy of the e-bulletin, you can get it through the link or the QR code that is on your screen right now. Inside the e-bulletin, you'll find all the information that you need for the service this morning and also about Ang Mo Kio Methodist Church. As we continue with Family and Life Month, today is also Worship Ministry's Dedication Sunday. During the service today, we will have a special segment where we recognize those who have responded to God's call to serve in the worship services ministries. There are many ministries that support the worship services here in Ang Mo Kio Methodist Church, and we will be dedicating these ministers who are serving in the worship service ministries. Right now, let us prepare ourselves to worship our God, who is calling to Himself worshippers who will come and worship Him in spirit and in truth. If you are able to, please rise to your feet and respond to the call to worship. Behold, how good and pleasant it is when we live together in unity.
It is like the precious oil upon the head, running down upon the beard, upon the beard of Aaron, running down on the collar of his robes.
It is like the dew of Hermon, which falls on the mountains of Zion.
For there the Lord has commanded the blessing, life forevermore.
Together,
unite us, Lord,
by your everlasting love.
Oh,
here to join us in worship. And now let me invite you to join me for this time of prayer. And let us pray. God, our Heavenly Father, we bow before you in prayer and to thank you for your faithfulness and leading your lives. We thank you also for the scripture has reminded us in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16 says that we can come with confidence to the throne of grace and find mercy and grace in time of need. And so here we are, Lord, lifting our hearts before you in prayer, that we know we will find the confidence in prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we'd like to start off full to thank you that Singapore has entered a new phase of era with the newly elected government. And we thank you for those who have been elected as MPs for the new government. And we want to uphold the government at this moment as they will take us through with this COVID-19, then we will come out stronger. So we want to remember those who are elected, that you grant them the diligence, the wisdom, the knowledge, and even the skill to govern, and couple with the passions and welfares of the people in mind. So Lord, we present to you our government at this moment in prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. At the same time, Lord, we are mindful also of those who are undergoing some financial difficulty due to the loss of jobs, loss of businesses, and we want to uphold the dear folks in prayer. The Lord, they were able to find help to the community and even to the help given by the government. So Lord, we pray for the direction and leading of their lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we also learn a new term called the new normal, which is really new to us. We never hear of in the last few months back, but here we are into this period of season. We pray for adaptation, adjustment, and the peace of mind to live what is given to us so that we can continue our life and with our family and with our children. So we pray for your wisdom be upon all of us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We also pray for Pastor in charge, Pastor Anthony, as he shoulders responsibilities of church heavily. Uphold him, Lord, at this moment of prayer. May grant him the wisdom, the strength, and even his health. And we pray that as he shares and preaches the word, that you grant him the anointing and the word of comfort and hope to all of us. And finally, for ourselves, we pray that we will continue to be steadfast in our faith and nothing will distract us. Remembering the Lord himself was with the disciples in the midst of the storm. And he could remove the storm and calm it so that to restore the faith into the lives of the disciples. So here we are, Lord, also in the midst of storm. And we believe Jesus is with us and he will calm the storm and grant us faith to overcome the fear that we are facing. So we want to present to you, Lord, this prayer and asking all this in Jesus' most precious name, we pray. Amen. Now together, beloved, let us sing the prayer the Lord had taught us, the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father in
Once again, good morning to all of you who are joining us for the online worship service. As we mentioned at the start of service, today is Worship Ministries Dedication Sunday. There are many ministries that are involved in the weekly worship services here in AMKMC Methodist Church. They include the ministries such as the ushers, the audiovisual crew, the musicians and singers, the choir, the dancers, the traffic wardens, and many others. They come together and play an integral part in our corporate worship to God. Though we may not have seen them for some time because of COVID-19, some of them continue to actively support our online worship services, while the others are standing by, ready at any moment to come back and support the worship services once they resume. As part of our Worship Ministries Dedication Sunday, we will also have our Serve God, Serve One Another initiative, organized by the Contemporary and Traditional Worship and Music Committees. Through this initiative, we hope to encourage you to step forward and serve. This year, both committees recognize the impact of COVID-19 on all church activities. So we will also be highlighting some other ministries outside of the worship services and how they continue to serve God's kingdom, whether it is pre-COVID-19 or even in the midst of the pandemic. In a moment, we will be presenting to you the various ministries under the umbrella of worship and music, and also some other ministries such as the youth ministry and the children's ministry. And as you watch this video, we pray that God will stir within your hearts a desire to serve.
At this juncture, we want to dedicate those who serve in the worship ministries before and during COVID and after COVID. So let's take a moment to pray and bless our brothers and sisters who step forth to serve. Father, we thank you for calling these men and women to serve in the worship services and in other ministries as well. Lord, as they continue to serve you, Father, we ask for your mighty blessings to be upon them. Keep them fervent in their service towards you. Let their hearts always be pure to serve you and you alone. May you, Lord, reward them also for their faithfulness, because God, you are a rewarder. And so we dedicate this, our brothers and sisters in Christ, into your loving hands. Watch over them in their coming in and going out. Bless them and their families and all that they are concerned about. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
At this point of the service, we would like to bring to you some announcements regarding upcoming events in Ang Mo Kio Methodist Church. The links and QR codes for the various events will be up on the screen, so do get ready for them. Last week, Pastor Anthony announced that we will be starting Holy Communion services from the 26th of July. We will still continue to worship together during the weekly online service video at 9 a.m. But in addition to that, we will be conducting small-scale Holy Communion services on Sunday. Registration for the first round of Holy Communion services will open tomorrow on the 20th of July. You will be able to register for any one of the six services, either on the 26th of July or the 2nd of August. On each of the Sundays, there will be three Holy Communion services, 10:30 a.m., 2 p.m. and 5 p.m., with each service capped at a maximum of 50 persons. After this round of Holy Communion services is completed, there will be a gap of 2 weeks before the next round of Holy Communion services on the 23rd and 30th of August. Please head over to the link on your screen to find out more about how to register and also about the Holy Communion services themselves. We look forward to communing with you at the Lord's table. Next, we would like to remind you that the registration for the Men's Fellowship for July will close tomorrow. This month's Men's Fellowship is on the 25th of July at 10:30 a.m. and the speaker is Mr. Benny Ong, who has experience in insurance, investment and estate planning. Registration details are in the e-bulletin and on our church website. We would also like to remind all church leaders that the Churchwide Leaders Meeting is on the 25th of July, 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. The details of the meeting has already been sent out to you, so please check your email and contact us if you have not received it. Lastly, we have a new announcement from the Children's Ministry, and this is for all of you who are parents with young children. The Children's Ministry strongly believes that a united family unit plays a vital role in the development and upbringing of children. And thus, they have planned a series of activities such as crafts, cookery, games and songs for you and your children. As the school holidays are coming, we would like to encourage you to do these activities with your children. You can go to the link that is on your screen to download the file for the suggested activities. And the Children's Ministry would love to hear from you and see how you and your children are spending time and doing these activities together. If you are a parent with young children and you're looking for some family activities to do this upcoming school holidays, please head over to the link to find out more. There are other announcements and upcoming events in the e-bulletin and on our website. We invite you to head over to our website at amkmc.org.sg to keep up to date with everything that is happening in Ang Mo Kio Methodist Church. Let's prepare to give God's tithes and our offering. You can give through the PayNow QR code that will be on your screen, and do remember to use your iBanking app to scan the QR code and not your regular QR code app. As you give your offering later, there will be a combined anthem by the musicians and singers from the traditional and contemporary services. Throughout the anthem, the PayNow QR code will remain in the corner of your screen for you to give. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity that we can worship you. And now we come and we worship you with our giving, Lord. We pray that you will guide each of us to the amount that you want us to give, and teach us, Lord, to trust in you for all things. We pray all this in Jesus' most precious name. Amen.
Thank you.
family and friends. Having given our offering, let us rise to our feet and praise God with the doxology.
Good morning, AMKMC family. Now, today's scripture passage is taken from 1 Timothy chapter 3, and just one verse, verse 13. Let me read it to us. For those who serve well as deacons gain a good standing for themselves and also great confidence in the faith that is in Christ Jesus. For those who serve well as deacons gain a good standing for themselves and also great confidence in the faith that is in Christ Jesus. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. Come, let us pray. Holy Spirit, we ask and invite you to take these precious words and help us to live them out so that we will not just be hearers of the word, but doers indeed. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now let me begin by asking a Bible trivia question. What was the first sport to be played in the Bible? What was the first sport to be played in the Bible? The answer, tennis. Why? Because Joseph served in Pharaoh's court. Genesis chapter 41, verse 46. Joseph served in Pharaoh's court. Do you get it? Okay, I know it's a very lame joke, but really, it was to get your attention about serving. I know we hear many messages from pastors challenging us to serve, but today I want to show us how serving is an integral part to Family and Life Month. What does serving have to do with Family and Life Month, you might wonder? Well, a lot, actually. Family is the first and primary place of service. Even before we are called to serve in church, God has put us in families to serve one another. Second, a lifetime and a lifestyle of humble service is a life that is most gloriously and most meaningfully lived. But before I unpack those statements, let me give the brief context for today's scripture passage in 1 Timothy chapter 3. And here in this chapter, Paul was giving Timothy a list of criteria to select overseers and deacons in church. In the original Greek, the word NIV translates for overseers is actually episkopos, from where we get the English word episcopal. It literally means bishop. And this is one reason why scholars believe that this letter is written sometime after Paul's death, when the church had evolved into an institution with proper organizational structure, with the bishop serving as an overseer and assisted by many deacons. Likewise, the word deacon comes from the Greek word diakonos, which literally means servants. In our Methodist structure here in Singapore, which, by the way, is autonomous, completely unlinked to American and British Methodism, in our Singapore Methodist system, we have one bishop, and the ordained pastors are called elders and deacons. In other denominations, like the Brethren churches or the Presbyterian churches, elders and deacons are made up of lay people, while full-time pastors are just called pastors. Without a doubt, today's passage is situated within the context of a church structure where there are certain people called to hold certain offices or roles. And 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 13 really is a call to exhort deacons to live a life of service well. However, if we were to simply stop here and confine this passage strictly to its historical context, then really there can be nothing to be learned from God's word today. However, like all scripture, while it's time-bound to a certain historical context, the truths of God's word are timeless. And the truth for today's word is straightforward. When we serve well, we will gain two wonderful things: a great reputation to stand before God, before men, and number two, a great confidence to stand before God. Let me repeat the two wonderful things we will gain when we serve well. Number one, a great reputation to stand before men. And number two, a great confidence to stand before God. First, a great reputation to stand before men. Recall Joseph, who began serving in Pharaoh's court. It was his humble service which eventually led to his greatness. Now, who doesn't want a great reputation? Or to flip the question around, who wants a bad reputation? I believe no one deliberately sets out, you know, to gain a terrible reputation. We all desire to have a good reputation, even if we fail to gain one eventually. That desire is innate. Even crooks and criminals, they want to get the great reputation of being ultra notorious. And Paul recognizes that innate desire too. In fact, in 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1, he even commends the person who aspires to the noble task of being a bishop. Paul did not rebuke anyone for having this godly ambition. Therefore, to desire a great reputation is not inherently evil. In my theology, we are all created for greatness because we are all created in the image of this great God. God is a great and glorious being, and being created in His image, we too desire to be great. We were born with the capacity and the potential for greatness. The problem, however, lies in two areas. Number one, our misplaced definitions of greatness. And number two, our misguided ways of achieving this greatness. The world ranks greatness in terms of power, authority. He or she who dominates and rules over others is great, while the one who is at the bottom of the food chain is the least, the weakest. The world promotes this belief that one must be unscrupulous, cold, mean in order to reach the top. The Bible, however, and this is chiefly exemplified by our Lord Jesus, the Bible paints a completely different picture of what greatness is and how this greatness is to be achieved. Luke chapter 22 records this fascinating account. A dispute also arose among the disciples as to which of them was to be regarded the greatest. And he said to them, Jesus said to them, "The kings of the Gentiles exercise lordship over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors. But not so with you. Rather, let the greatest among you become as the youngest, and the leader as one who serves. For who is the greater, one who reclines at the table or one who serves? Is it not the one who reclines at the table? But I am among you as the one who serves." Notice here that Jesus also did not correct the disciples' desire to be great or to be the greatest even. He never scolded them for their aspiration because he knows that being great, this desire, is imputed through God's image. However, Jesus does correct them on their understanding of what greatness is and how to become great. Jesus says, "The kings of the Gentiles exercise lordship over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors. But not so with you. Rather, let the greatest among you become as the youngest and the leader as one who serves." In other words, it is not the position, but the posture that determines one's greatness. Let me say that again. It is not the position, but the posture that determines one's greatness. We have just had our general election, and while this subject is still fresh in all our minds, is it not true that the MPs and ministers we respect the most are those who are willing to get on the ground, to get their hands dirty, those who are willing to serve? In this passage in Luke, Jesus asks a rhetorical question. For who is the greater, the one who reclines at the table or the one who serves? Surely it is the one who reclines at the table. And indeed, Jesus was referring to himself as one who is reclining at the table being greater than the servant. Yet, Jesus chose to flip the table and washed his disciples' feet instead. In so doing, Jesus shows us that the way to greatness is not by barking commands and orders down at others, but it is by bending our knees and to serve others with humility. The posture of humility and service is what makes us great. I will never forget a scene in which I understood what it means to truly live a life of service, how we as Christians and Christian leaders ought to serve. This scene took place many years ago, and I can't remember the exact event. I was still in CityAlight Methodist Chapel, my former church. Can't remember if I was just a youth leader or already a junior pastor. Those of you who work more closely with me know that I have a very bad memory. Anyway, basically, we had a school, we had a church event in the school canteen. CityAlight Methodist Chapel is located within Geylang Methodist School Primary. And so after the event, almost everyone had left and I was about to leave too. Just then, at the final moment, I noticed my pastor in charge walk in, holding a mop in her hands, and she started to clean up the canteen all by herself. I honestly cannot remember what I did that day. Did I leave or did I stay back to help her? But I will never forget that one scene. The pastor in charge cleaning the canteen after everyone has left. And you know what is the best part? She never told anyone about it, even after the event. There was no debrief after the event for the staff to stay back and to help clean up as well. There was no mention of what she did over the pulpit or even in the small talks that we had. Nothing. Just pure, humble service, despite being in a position of greater authority. And so today I want to honour her before men. Her name is Reverend Nga Mi Hi, the pastor who shepherded me for the most part of my Christian life. And she probably won't even hear about this sermon today. But here's the thing we got to recognize. A great reputation will spread even if you do nothing. A great reputation will naturally spread. And this is what exactly Paul was telling Timothy. Those who serve well will gain a good standing, an excellent standing before men. You see, this is an unchanging eternal truth. All who serve well will naturally gain a great reputation over time. Why? Because God is faithful and just, and God our Father is a rewarder. He will see to it that His children, those who serve well, will receive the rewards that are due to them on earth and also in the life to come. So that's the first thing. Those who serve well gain a good reputation before men. And then Paul goes on to write, those who serve well also gain a great confidence of their faith in Christ Jesus. The Greek word here for confidence really means boldness. Those who serve well are bold in their faith. Surely that goes without saying. If you have been faithfully serving the Lord, surely you'll be bold to stand before the Lord, expecting Jesus to say to you, well done, good and faithful servant. And so in a reverse engineering sort of way, I want to challenge all of us to start serving. If you haven't already done so, start serving God in one way or another. Today, we also highlight Serve God, Serve One Another Sunday. It's the time that we highlight those who serve in worship, music, in the services, ministries. But really, service is not just confined to what happens officially. Service can happen at the cell group level, where you choose to host the Zoom account, for example, even though you're not the CGL. Service can also happen, for example, when you choose to buy food and groceries for a brother or sister in Christ who is in need. The ways to serve are endless. Yes, unfortunately, we only track those who serve in an official capacity when we pray for them and dedicate them. But if you serve, even in your own quiet way, you will surely gain an excellent reputation, as God's word says, and more importantly, you'll be confident and bold of your faith in Christ Jesus. Over the years, I have been a pastor. I've met many who had little assurance of their faith in Christ Jesus. To some extent, I don't really blame them. After all, faith cannot be measured, right? Plus, God is unseen. So how does one justify one's faith in Christ Jesus? 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 13, I believe, gives us a secret. When we start serving and serve well, we become more and more assured of our faith and our courage in Christ Jesus. When we start serving and continue to serve well, we become more and more assured of our faith and courage in our Lord Jesus Christ. Do you know why? The book of James tells us, faith without works is dead. James chapter 2, verse 17. Faith without works is dead. Our works will reveal our faith. Faith is invisible, right? But works are visible. If we have lived a life of service, just as Jesus did, it shows that we truly believe what Jesus has taught, that the greatest is the one who serves. We have demonstrated our faith through our action. And therefore, if you want confidence of your faith in Christ Jesus, serve. Let me now return to the two statements I made at the start of this sermon. First, family is the first and primary place of service. Even before we are called to serve in church, God has put us in families to serve one another. No matter what our titles may be on the outside, when we step home, the truth is these titles count for nothing. Those with young kids are the best evidence of this reality. Try telling your two-year-old who's having a tantrum that you are the CEO of an MNC and see if that helps you in calming their kid down. Or maybe you can try telling your teenager you are a high flyer and therefore you have no time for them and see if that brings them closer to you. I think we all know this to be true. Our work titles count for nothing or count for little at home. But sadly, many people who are heroes, great at work, are zeros at home. I pray that this will not be true for us at AMKMC Church. I pray we will make our homes our top priority. There is really no point being a hero at work and being a zero at home. You know, by default, our children will naturally see us as heroes, parents as their first heroes. This is the natural design. It's only when their trust is eroded over time because we have lost our privileged position by lording it over them instead of learning to walk alongside with them. But the good news is this, it's never too late. It's never too late because God's Word always has that grace and power to transform our lives and our families if we choose to obey them. So how do we serve our own families? For example, maybe there's someone very stressed in the family. Let's step up and help them more. Is there a task to be done at home? Don't wait for others to do them. There are many things we can do on our own initiative, like cleaning the toilets, washing the dishes, buying the groceries, so and so forth. The key really is to put on a servant's mindset and to look out for the interests of your family members, just as Philippians chapter 2 says this, do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, count others more significant than yourselves. And this passage doesn't just apply to life in church. It is true for all spheres in life. Let each one look not only to his own interests, but also to the interests of others. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus. It's available for us in Christ Jesus to put on this mindset. Listen to the Word of God here. Who, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of man, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Notice here, Jesus demonstrated true humility and obedience in the primary context of a family. Jesus was humble and obedient to who? God, his Father. It's in the context of a family that Jesus demonstrated service. I truly believe that God has allowed COVID-19 to turn our attention to our home front. So let's not waste this crisis. Let's get our homes in order first by serving our family members more. A businessman was once asked his Bible study group, how can you tell if you have a servant attitude? How can you tell that you have a servant attitude? The reply came back, by the way you react when you're treated as one. By the way you react when you're treated as one. I don't know about you, but my children treat me like a servant all the time. Pa, can you do this? Pa, can you do that? You know, and they don't always say thank you. Most of the time, they don't say thank you. I'm telling all of us that home really is the best training ground for a servant's heart. Home is the place where we lay down our pride because really we don't carry it with us, our titles with us at home. And we learn to practice humility and servanthood. If you return to 1 Timothy chapter 3, you will see that the bishop as well as the deacons both had to manage their households well. Now, how do you think they managed their households well? Do you think they lorded it over their families? Or is it more likely that they put on the mind of Christ, they served at home first with humble, loving, yet firm authority? Again, before our church really can be a home with a heart, our individual homes must be a place with heart. And may God help all of us in this godly endeavour. Now, I wish to conclude this sermon by reminding us that a lifetime and a lifestyle of humble service really is a life that is most gloriously and most meaningfully lived. Martin Luther King Jr. once said this, life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? What are you doing for others? That is why Jesus, who is the wisest person ever, had earlier taught in John chapter 12, verses 24 to 25, very truly I tell you, unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds. Anyone who loves their life will lose it, while anyone who hates their life in this world will keep it for eternity. You see, the paradox is this. When you die to yourself by living for others, that is when you truly live. When you die to yourself and you learn to live for others by serving them, that's when you truly live. But when you live for yourself and you ignore the cries of others, you would have lived a wasted life. May I remind all of us once again that it is a life given to service that is a life most meaningfully lived. The story was told of a group of students from Harvard who, when they came back to the school to celebrate their 25th anniversary of their graduation, the Alumni Association put together a booklet with photographs of the students and their comments about where their lives had taken them over the previous 25 years. In one of those books, next to the picture of a very handsome young man, were written these simple words: "Making $10 million before I was 40 years old didn't turn out to be as wonderful as I thought it was going to be. Making $10 million before I was 40 didn't turn out to be as wonderful as I thought it was going to be." You can't help wondering what he was trying to say in that one statement. So friends, make no mistake here. A life that is fully alive, a life that is gloriously lived, is one that is given to service, especially God's service. After all, God gave up His life for you. Let me close with this final story. Once upon a time, there was a hammer. And this hammer was left unused in the toolbox for a long time. And let me say here, I have no political inclinations, right? Just a story. And so it felt really useless. Life was meaningless. One day, a boy came along, opened up the toolbox, found the hammer, and used it to smash tree trunks and branches. The hammer knew it was wrong, but it felt good to be used anyway. Sometime later, a thief came around and used that same hammer to smash the glass windows to gain access into homes. Again, the hammer knew it was wrong, but it felt, you know, good to be used rather than to be left unused. Finally, after a long while, the owner of the toolbox, the carpenter, returned from his trip, took the hammer out and used it to hammer some nails into the table he was making. When the hammer struck the nail on his head, suddenly awakened and discovered the true purpose he had been made for. The hammer's purpose was to serve the greater good all along. You know, we are very much like the hammer. God has designed us to serve others for good. But many of us, before we found ourselves in the hands of the Master, we may have been misled to use our lives for other purposes, to live for ourselves. But when we discover God's true intention for us, that we were meant to serve, that's when we find ourselves truly alive. Unfortunately for many of us, in our impatience to discover God's very specific purpose for our lives, we would rather use our lives for our own selfish desires rather than trusting God to wait for Him, to let Him use us as He desires. My prayer for all of us today is that we will once again offer ourselves afresh to God, God our loving Father, and that we will use our lives to serve others for good. Come, let us pray. Dear God, Heavenly Father, we thank You that You have created us for greatness. But Lord, forgive us for how we have tried to achieve greatness or how we have misguided notions of what greatness means. Lord, we pray once again, You will teach us to serve, beginning from our homes and from there extending to other communities and to the faith community. We thank You for Your word. Once again, we pray, You help us not to be just hearers of Your word, but doers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And here are today's class mini questions. If you want to find out a way to serve, do feel free to contact us, any of us, in the church office. God bless.
Thank you, Pastor Anthony, for sharing God's Word with us today. As we allow God's Word to sink into our minds and our hearts, if you want to respond to God's call to serve, whether it is in your family or in a church ministry, we invite you to sing this song together with us, the song, Heart of a Servant. But more than that, we want to encourage you to take a step of faith and to make your response into an action. A link and a QR code will be appearing on your screen, and it will lead you to the Serve God, Serve One Another electronic form. In this form, you will be able to show your appreciation to anyone who is serving in any of the ministries here in AMKMC Methodist Church. But more importantly, you will be able to indicate if you wish to serve in any of the ministries here in our church. Jesus said, "The wise man is the one who hears God's words and does them." And so our prayer is that as you hear God's voice today, that you will be spurred into action as well.
Standing in awe of your grace, setting my feet in your ways, entering into your presence to behold you face to face. God of all heaven and earth, holding me in your embrace, unfailing love that surrounds me. Oh God, I stand amazed. By Jesus, my Lord, you're the love of my life. Wherever you go, wanna be by your side. No longer I, but Christ living in me, serving you for all eternity. My eyes set on you in this race that I run. No longer my ways, let your will be done. Make me a servant, my heart's ever true, clinging to the cross, I'll follow you, I'll follow you. My ways, let your will
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word this morning. Thank you for reminding us of your call to serve. Holy Spirit, we ask for your help so that we will be able to serve you in all areas of our lives. And as we learn to serve, may we see your heartbeat for the people around us. We ask all of this in Jesus' most precious name. Amen. Thank you for joining us for service this morning. Before we go and before Pastor Emmanuel pronounces the benediction, we would like to remind you to respond to God's call to serve by filling up the Serve God, Serve One Another electronic form. We will get back in touch with you and partner with you in your journey to serve in Ang Mo Kio Methodist Church. If you'd like to get in touch with us, you can do so through our website or our social media platforms. If you need to revisit any of the announcements from earlier on, or if you want to find out more about how to give, you can also do that through our website. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you have not already done so and click on the notification bell. Also, please like, share and comment on this video if you have been blessed by the service this morning, so that others may be able to find this video and be blessed by it too. Pastor Emmanuel, I pass the time to you.
Thank you, Alpha. Ang Mo Kio family, thank you for joining us for the online worship service. And as you remember Pastor Anthony's sermon on serving others, let us go forth and serve others in love, God's love towards us and also towards other people. Let us now receive the benediction. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and the abundant love of God and His shalom peace be with you now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you, Ang Mo Kio family. So great that you are able to join us, and we would love to see you next week for our online worship service. Take care and God bless. See you.